Greetings and welcome back to this War of Mine, and today, 23. Marco has just returned from the warehouse where he managed to steal from the armed thugs without resorting to violence. We have two electronic parts. That is a fantastically good haul, regardless of anything else he brings back at that point. Now, we want everyone to quickly eat, and then we're going to go ahead and have pretty much everyone go and sleep as well. Come on, let's get everyone down here. Marin, since you can be one of the last people to go there, go ahead and upgrade that. Right, Marco, sleep time. Pavle, ooh, okay. Oh, no, wait, sorry. We need you to first make the thermometer, do we not? Yes. Bruno, let's get you upstairs. There we go, that's all we need. Go ahead and make. Up you go, there we are. Pavle, go ahead and get some sleep. There we are. You can grab your food. Ah, we are doing well. Now there is a little part of me that's like, well, maybe I should actually have someone stay up, because otherwise we might not be able to get everyone to respond in time to anyone come to the door. But here we go, let's get that going. We're at 12 degrees at the moment. As soon as that's built, we'll pop some fuel on the fire and hopefully warm this house up for a little bit extra efficiency. We also need to finish building that. We also need 3 filters to make sure we get plenty of water. On the whole, we're doing fairly well, I would say. All right, let's make sure this gets finished. Put some fuel in there. There we go, that's fantastic. Definitely go and do that. Actually, Bruno, sorry. We were paused in the middle of doing so much work yesterday. So we've got quite a few things we need to do. So we'll just get that done. Then Marion can go and eat. We've got someone at the door. We've got 2 people at the door. Oh, is it the children? Let's, we'll be there in a moment, children. Right, Marion, quickly up there. I wonder how their mother's doing. If it is, in fact, the children. Maybe this is a repeating quest, and we're just going to have to give them more medicine. We've got enough medicine. We can give you some. Hello again. We're hungry. Yeah, okay. We've got plenty of food. Hi again. Thanks to you, our mum is getting better, but she's still weak. And we have no food left. We are very hungry. Can you give us something to eat, please? I could give you an actual meal. I'm gonna have to say maybe later. I'll be all right. It'll be all right. They didn't say no. Oh, I want to. Can't we just give you food? I'm rolling in food right now. Not literally rolling in it, you understand, of course. But we have sufficient amount of food. Right, Bruno, go ahead and sleep for now. Oh, man, that sucks. That truly sucks. I'm not happy with that at all. I would very much have preferred to have been able to give you some food. Like, we had food there. Marion wouldn't have minded. Marion understands. Damn it. Okay, we're going to have to keep our eyes out then for some just regular food, I suppose. Right, we want another 3 of these. Let's make that so. Some of our listeners report that military have been committing acts of violence against citizens. Those scoundrels. What have we got here? The rabble and government forces have engaged in violent skirmishes throughout. We've already seen that one. It will update here whenever something changes. So let's check on the weather forecast, shall we? What's the weather going to be like? Not quite there. There we go. It will get much colder. Snowfall is expected in the southeast of Grasnavia. Let's give a warm hug to the people of Pogran. Where's the music? There we go. That'll do. Well, not happy about that situation. I mean, we literally had food just sitting there. Feels especially ungood that we couldn't do anything about that. We've got plenty. We could get some moonshine, but I feel poor Bruno has been up and about and he needs his rest at this point. All right, let's start loading these up. We've got quite a few of them now. We've made an extra, a spare 3, effectively. But that'll do for tomorrow. There we go. We are running a little bit low on time at the moment. I haven't managed to do this as well as I would have liked to. But still, that little heater there is doing remarkable work for us. There we go. All three of them are set. We haven't got this set up yet, but we'll work on that shortly. We have got two right now. I can't believe they wanted that specifically. I mean, it makes sense because it's not going to hurt them carrying it around, but damn. Okay, what have we got? Let's see. We could... No, there's really nothing we want to do here. We want the saw blade, really, but... We could have another one of these as the next thing we want, I think. Do we have a saw blade? We do not. Okay, then. How much does it cost for you to make it? It costs... actually, not too many for you to make it. Still, I'll wait for Marin. Oh, Bruno's back up. Right, Bruno, get over there. As soon as Marin is up, we'll see if Marin can make us a saw blade for cheaper. Because I'm fancying he can. Alright, let's see what we can make here. We want as much of this as we can. There we go. We'll get 3 moonshine out of that. Go ahead and make it. We are going to want some more fuel for the fires. Let's make some of that. Let's go ahead and make... We're going to want at least... Let's get 4. That'll cover us for a couple of days. Is there anything we can chop down in here? No. We have pretty much gone through everything in here. Right, well, Marin, when you wake up, I'm going to have you race over here. And hopefully, we'll be able to get the saw blade made soon. I'm not sure if Marco is going back to the warehouse. I mean, that might be pressing our luck a little bit. But at the same time... maybe. Right, can you move? Oh, you don't need to go down there. Marin, run, Marin! Like the wind! Show us the meaning of haste! I'm fairly certain that is not the meaning. Especially when you were going up the ladder. That was more like a leisurely stroll. Go ahead and make one then. It looks like it's exactly the same, but I don't know if you're going to get it in time. I'm fairly certain you are not, in fact. Come on. Come on, you're almost there. Please. No, yes, no, yes, I think we got it. Maybe. Okay, so it looks like, are things moving around still? Or are these exactly the same places they were before? I think they may actually be the same places they were before. Right, you're going to be scavenging. You're going to be guarding, as are you, as are you. Now the question is, where are we going to be scavenging? We could go back to a place we've already been and chop down some... timber and fuel. That's always an option. Hotel. No, I'm not inclined to go to the hotel. I've already gotten a lot from them. We could go to the city hospital and trade. Shout school, we could go there and gather resources by sewing stuff down. The warehouse, there's 51% of the stuff there. They've got lots of food, some meds, huge amounts of weapons, huge amounts of parts. No. I think it is time that we visited a new location, and maybe we can help in some way. If you want to get laid for a can of meat, which we don't, then this is the place to go, but we wouldn't mind perhaps getting, maybe we could trade or something. I don't know what we're going to be able to do, but there's danger, there's possible trade. I mean, what we'd be trading for, I'm not sure, but we're going to go on a bit of a reconnaissance. Marco, I want you down there with some weapons. What should we take for trade? I could take some of this maybe for trade. Maybe. Yeah, we'll take that for trade and we'll see what we can do. Marco, let's find out. Let's find out what's going on. Okay, it's my first time in this kind of place. Well done, Marco. Don't worry. We're here to protect you. Right, we'll take that. What's going to go on in here? Is anyone in there? No. Okay, let's open that up then. No, it won't open. Fair enough. We've got to go down then. Let's be careful and see what we can find out as we walk around. We have brought a saw with us, so we can go through there, perhaps. It's trash, mostly. Among it lie a fashionable handbag, torn as if someone had ripped it open, not sparing any thought to a damaged zipper. A tiny framed photo of a young man and a pocket notebook. Whoever tossed these here wasn't their owner. Okay, that's pretty much made up my mind about what this place is like. And I'm fairly certain that's probably why it was there. It's like, here, if you want to stop feeling guilty about what you may or may not be about to do to the people in charge here, there's something to absolve you of all of your guilt. Contrived game is contrived. Bullets, casings, and gunpowder. Let's see what we can do. Let's be nice and careful and thorough, though, here. There's no reason to rush around. But at least one person is probably not here by choice. Right. Oh, we actually do have a bullet, do we? Okay. There we go. That'll make getting in a little bit easier next time. I should possibly have left that as a loot drop off point. What's going on in here? Doesn't seem to be anyone in there. Wow, okay. This place is enormous. Alright. I want to have a look downstairs first. See what we can see. Hello? Yeah, we'll saw through this. This is great, but I can cut through it with my saw blade. Well done, Marco. Well done. And unfortunately, that is the end of your saw blade. Now, let's have a look what we can find in here. What? Oh, some more bullets. Okay. Well, I suppose that'll help our survivors fend off any bandit raids. Some more moonshine. Okay, well, I guess I shouldn't have brought my moonshine. I mean, at this point, I'm fairly certain we're not going to be trading with anyone. But you never know. It's probably best that I... It was best that I came here prepared for that eventuality. No, can't get up there. All right, then. Looks like we are going through here no matter what. But we may want to try and get back there if we can. Ah, there's a ladder. Okay. Let's close this door, though. Let's try and leave the place as we found it, so as not to alert anyone, just in case. Right, nothing there. Oh, really? That's a jip. Okay, there's people in there. All right, let's avoid that for now. Doesn't look like that's a window, at the very least. That, maybe, though. Aha. Always look for alternate ways in. If the game has gone to the effort of making an alternate route, it's usually worth taking it, in my humble opinion. Can I get up there? Yes, I can. Okay. This is a reconnaissance mission, first and foremost. We're going to see what we can do here, and then we'll come back better armed to do it, I think. And we'll take this. Lots of ammunition, my lord. I'm not sure how I feel about that, because honestly, it's more or less wasted on me. It's like feeding strawberries to a donkey. I'm not going to use guns, generally. Only trash and dirt here. Okay, well, what's in here, then? We are going to find... Ooh, electrical parts! That was useful. Okay, we've got two rounds. Alright, let's... Oh, you don't know how to get there? Fair enough. We'll have to go back around this way, then. Okay. Oh, we're kind of throwing caution to the wind here now. We're over halfway through, so we've just got a little bit of time left. We want to see what we can work out. Let's have a look inside. Right. Saw blade we need over there. Another saw blade. Okay, that was worth having a peek at the very least. I think we just got another electrical part as well. Oh dear, something's moving down there. Oh yeah, okay. We're almost ready to leave. Let's have a look. Is there anything I can see through here? Hidey hole. Looks like possibly a back way in, maybe. That looks like I'll be able to break it from this side. Yeah, it's been boarded up from this side, so I should be able to tear that open. There's also something in there. Let's have a look through here, though. What are we going to see? We have really got to kind of be going soon, so... No. Something blocking the door from the other side. Can we get up there at all? Because this is the last couple of things we're going to do before we leave. Let's have a look what we've got. Don't worry, we are going to be back here. I'm fairly certain that we've investigated enough to clear our conscience of whatever Marco's going to have to do when he returns. But I'm as much as the bandits were stealing from aid convoys. Ooh, actually, I'd rather go this way. I should have closed that door, really. I'm going to feel more vindicated in murdering thugs here than I would anywhere else. Okay, that's it. We need to leave. Got all these doors open, and there's a gentleman over there. Well, gentleman may be too kind a word, really, but we're going to leave. We've seen enough. We will return. Okay, let's see what happened overnight. Unfortunately, we didn't get any canned food, which is a shame because we do want to get some canned food for those children. If only they would accept meals. Bruno's a bloody good cook, don't you know? Tonight's a really good haul. We've been raided. Someone tried to rob us. They really meant business, but we managed to fend them off. Thankfully, we were all armed. None of us was wounded, and the attackers didn't steal anything. We were able to defend ourselves. You know, I'm starting to wonder if perhaps I'm just hitting on the best combination. They're all rested when it comes to guarding, and they've all got weapons, and we've heavily fortified our home. So the attackers, regardless of how interested they are in taking this place, never have the means to do so. Right, go ahead and collect stuff from there. I would also then like you over here. Where's Pavle? Right, I hope we can manage to keep it warm in here. I'm sure we will. Alright, go downstairs. We've got some fuel. Go get it on the fire. Bruno, go ahead over there. Oh, you got a bio. I was in my restaurant watching the patrons argue over the dinner and not really noticing the news showing some heavy fighting when it hit me. They're showing Poggerin outskirts. It's my town, where my friend lives. I don't know what I was hoping for when I rushed out the door to the bus station. Well, you do care about people, don't you? You just hide it really well. Right, okay, actually, Bruno, you don't need to be up here. Marin, damn blast. There we go, Marin. Head over here instead. I want another sword blade from you. You're tired, don't worry, you'll get to sleep in just a moment. Right, I want another sword blade, yes, please. Right, Pavle, let's get down, check on the radio. Bruno, go sleep. We're pretty good. We've got plenty of trade goods at this point. Some classical music. What's the weather going to be like? Always best to check. Getting much colder still. No change there. Ooh, more atrocities committed by the military. This morning, a mortar shell exploded in crowded Poggerin marketplace, killing and wounding many people. Oh, that is terrible. People are scouring the streets and abandoned houses for everything that can be eaten, burned, or traded. If aid doesn't reach the city soon, the situation will become dire. The situation is already dire. You can hear the mortars being fired just now. Okay, well, I mean, you know, it's atrocious that mortars killed anyone. I shouldn't be making a big deal out of it being civilians. I know soldiers, you know, they kind of signed up for it, but ultimately a lot of soldiers are doing it because they want to protect people, not because they want to go out and actually fight. They're doing it out of a sense of duty rather than a sense of bloodlust, so them getting killed by mortars is just as savage as anyone getting killed for anything, really, when you think about it. It's just the civilians, it's more a case of they had no idea what was going on. They were just trying to buy food, possibly had their kids there. All sorts of atrocities going on. Right, well, let's see. We've got a bit of fertilizer. We've got some extra food. Oh, they're back. I want to give you food so badly. Bruno, can we cook them some food? Get up there. I'm really not sure what we can do. Let's see if we can make them two meals, and maybe they'll accept that in exchange. We'll see what we can do. Have a heart? We do! We do! We're trying so desperately to have a heart. Bruno, need two meals. You may as well cook four, actually. Yeah, go ahead and cook all four meals. We've got enough of everything to do it. You can make it now, and then we'll see if we can trade two of them away. Alright, you come along up. Pavle needs to sleep quite badly. And Bruno needs to sleep as well quite badly. Marco, go talk to the children. Quick smart. There we are. But there should be enough food there for them now, if they'll accept it. Please accept it. Marco's desperate to help people. Can you share some real food with us, please? Pretty please? Tammy's heard. We can't find anything good to eat, so we've been eating all sorts of gross things in the last couple of days. We can't help you. I understand. I'll try elsewhere. Oh man, that feels so horrible. We've got food there. You could come in and eat. Silly game. That makes me feel bad, and I have everything there. We could even give them some moonshine. Not that we should. But, you know, we've got a really well-stocked house, and because we don't have the specific tinned goods that they're interested in, they ignore everything else. How wretched a situation to find ourselves in, truly. We'd share some food with these hungry children, if only we had any left. Well, at least you recognize that we don't, but we do. That's the annoying thing. It was sad that we couldn't help those hungry children. Yes, yes, it was. No one's content now. I wish we could have helped those children. So do I. Bruno doesn't care. Bruno was asleep through the whole thing. Mind you, so was Pavle, so we don't really have much of an excuse there, honestly. Ah, how frustrating. Right, well, let's see if we can't make a couple more filters. Oh, we can't. We are actually that low on materials now. We can't even make filters. Okay. Can I afford to send you to the brothel tonight, Marco? I want to. And yet... We are starting to run low. Thankfully, we have enough to make one more sword blade. Okay, you're going to use the last bit of our gear to go and help at the brothel, if you can. Hopefully you can. We don't know, but it's all we can do to try. We're going to go ahead and we're going to end the day now. Everyone is awake. All right, Marco, you're going to be scavenging and everyone else is going to be on guard once again. And it is exactly the same places. We're going to be heading to the brothel. 47% of the stuff in the brothel is taken. That can't be true. Or we've seen 47% of it. Some food, lots of meds, huge amounts of weapons, lots of parts, possible danger. Possible trade, danger. Well, we're not going there to trade. We are going on a rescue mission. Oh, we actually already had one. Oh, drat, damn and blast. I wasted that then. Okay, we're going to arm ourselves. We're going to take all we need to try and deal with this. We do have one filter remaining, and that's going to be quite useful for us. But, okay. Marco, fingers crossed. Let's see if we can get through this without getting hurt. We could hack up things here if we needed more materials, and that is certainly an option. Let's close that door, and then let's get up here. Okay, lots of things that we can break all over the place. Let's try not to move too quickly, though, otherwise we will make noise, and we don't really want to make noise right now. Right, up we go. There's someone standing down there, probably a guard, I imagine. Right. I mean, the other fellow was talking to him as if it was some sort of commenting on his wares, which is rather crass, but there we are. Let's move through. We've got a hidey hole. Someone's down there. Is it a good or a bad someone? That is the question. Let's have a peek. What are we going to see? Ah, damn it, I should have brought a shovel. Okay, well, there's not much we can do. Oh, drat. In we go. Okay, we're just gonna hang out. Oh, actually, maybe you can just move across there. Is someone coming this way? Anyone? No one? Okay. Perhaps I should have just been watching there for a while. And welcome back to a rather abrupt end to the last night's activity. And yeah, there we go. Marco died. Marco was killed while looking for supplies because someone sent me a Steam message on the one time that I forgot to turn Steam offline before I actually started recording a game. I don't think there are words in the English language to express how disappointed I am in this situation. To explain, I received a message, and it wasn't their fault. They weren't to know. I mean, I guess it showed clearly that I was playing This War of Mine, and if they followed the series, it would have been a reasonable assumption to make that I was actually recording it. But they sent me a message. It popped up, and the game lost focus whilst I'm in the middle of the last fight. My recording software then just had an aneurysm. I'm not sure how much of the recording is preserved. I did quickly check the file before I started the game back up again. But it looks like the beginning is fine, so I'll just have to find out where I need to lay the cut in the actual raid. But whilst I was not paying attention, whilst the game had lost focus, music was still playing, everything, my computer was just having a hard time, I think. But Marco didn't make it out. It seems that things are going to be difficult from now on. Poor Marco, he was doing his best, bless him. He went out there with the best of intentions, and to die like this, that is not a good time. At least we weren't raided, but hungry, sad. Marco was killed last night. I'm glad it wasn't me. I have to be careful. Well, yeah, that's true. What have you got to say? It's really sad that Marco is no longer among us. We will relate his story to his close ones after the war. That's a bit better, Marin. And Pavle. Oh, Marco, we have to make sure this doesn't happen to anyone else. Yes, we do. But I'm not sure how we can do that. I'm not even sure how I feel about continuing this run. I will, obviously. But I do feel that this may have switched from I was starting to feel a little bit confident that we may have actually managed to win as much as you can win in any situation like this, but now I'm really not sure. And that could just be my disappointment talking. So I'm probably going to take a little break from this war of mine, at least for a day or so, whilst I consider how best to proceed. But that is the end of this episode on a rather sad and bitter note. Much like the survivors here who've just recently lost Marco, we have lost him too. And that is going to be hard to recover from. But I do hope you enjoyed the episode up until the sudden and abrupt crash, both in the recording software and our fortunes. And I hope you will be joining me for the next. But until then, and as always, do take care. Oh, and by the way, if you are watching this, don't feel bad about sending me the message. Honestly, it was my own fault for not turning Steam off. Take care.